fireworks tonight in the third debate between Congressman Steve King and his opponent, Christie Vilsack.
That's right, Emily Price, the only live reporter in the town of Hampton tonight. Emily?
For a one-hour debate, they covered a lot of ground here in Hampton, from everything from No Child Left Behind and the deficit to immigration and voter ID laws. Hundreds of people got to hear where the congressman and Mrs. Vilsack stand. The debate took place in this historic 99-year-old Windsor Theater in Hampton, and the fireworks started right away and would happen in nearly every answer. Vilsack would point out how she believes King has failed in Congress, and King would then point out that Vilsack is simply attacking and not offering ideas.
And Congressman King has had the opportunity to take up an education bill. He's had the opportunity to vote for education, and he has chosen to support the Ryan bill, which would remove billions of dollars from education, and I would like to call on him to reconsider his votes in that respect.
Well, I think by now we see the pattern. At the end of the gentlelady's time, she's going to ask me a question and make a charge, and I'm not going to spend my time defending baseless charges here tonight. I'm going to address the issues as they're asked by the moderator, but just watch the pattern as it unfolds.
When Congressman came to office, we had a $6 trillion debt. Now we have a $16 trillion debt. And he's had 10 years to balance the budget, and he hasn't done it.
I'm keeping track of baseless charges. I'm up to 8. And I'm going to continue to talk about policy and issues and how we get this country in the right direction. But my record is strong and it's clear. And first of all, the budget's going to get balanced when we have a majority of the people in the House and the Senate and a president who believe in doing so.
IOWA, Christie Vilsack, all the way.
Where this is the third debate between King and Vilsack, and four more are planned. Tonight, supporters heard a stark contrast on voter ID laws. King wants to force voters to bring an ID to the polls, while Vilsack is against it. King said there is no part of the Affordable Health Care Act that's worth keeping, and Vilsack says there are 8 or 9 things that she would like to change in the Health Care Act. Now, the next debate is 10 days away, and that will be held in Orange City. Todd?
All right, Emily Price, live in Hampton. Thanks, Emily.